mercy is pouring on me. I messed up, but you still love me.
You know when you texting a girl,
grace and mercy,
and you saying things you ain't supposed to say,
is pouring on me.
But you still love me.
A sinner, but you still love me.
Your grace is sufficient, God.
Still love you, still love you, still love you, still love you, still love you.
Sometimes I get on the stage and
still love you, still love you, still love you,
you know,
still love you,
still love you, still love you.
Welcome back to the Best Gospel Praise Talk Show in America, the TMA Radio Show. Tonight, I'm your host, Minister Aquajan. We're just going to kick it live and talk about the community, the news. We're going to have the best music for your ears. And what's up with America? What we got going on? Hey, if you want to call us up, 919-521-4741. Again, that number is 919-521-4741. And if you need prayer, 919-526-4916. So we got the weather coming up. We got news and more. So we want you just to stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
Inside, I can feel the pain. Leaving the old ways, yeah, I know the change.
I know it.
Your old friends still love you, but it's like life going different ways. And God put a church fam in your life, but it's uncomfortable. It really don't feel right.
Weird.
So you try and bring your old friends with you. But God, like, I don't need the crew, that's why I called you.
I see.
And God called you so he can get you right.
Get me
and
right.
Put you in a position so he can draw them to Jesus.
Grace and mercy. Pouring on me, I messed up, but you still love me. Grace and mercy is pouring on me. A sinner, but you still love me. Still love you, still love you, still love you, still love you, still love. Still love you, still love you, still love you, still love you, still love. Still love you, still love you, still love you, still love.
The greater the struggles you face, the greater the challenges you go through, the greater the turmoil in your life is all the indication that Satan has assigned assassins to terminate you from reaching your designated target. He will do anything to overwhelm you, belittle you, to rip you of your confidence, your self-esteem. He doesn't mind how much you shout and how much you dance.
All right, let's go into the weather. Let's go into your weather forecast. Tonight, low of 68 degrees. Tuesday, partly cloudy, chance of thunderstorm, high of 93 with a low of 70. Wednesday, partly cloudy, chance of thunderstorm, high of 91 with a low of 70. And that's your 2.5 forecast. All right, we're just checking it out. We want you to know that there are some teens that initially was said they were charged, five of them, in a drug deal that went bad. Young people, I want you to know that teens need to stay off the drugs. A young girl lost her life over a drug sale that went bad. Now four young people are charged, what was charged as of yesterday, with first degree murder for the hit and run. But they are saying that, the attorney saying that it was not a murder, but an accidental accident. But either way, you know, is it going to be a murder or accident? There's a young person that lost their life. She lost her life because of a drug sale that went down, went wrong. And young people, you gotta do what's right, man. You know, I mean, you just gotta do better. You know, young people. And if you don't have anyone positive that you can be around, you need to find you someone in the church. You need to find you someone in school that can be a role model to you. Because everything at the house might not be right, but you can have a chance if you just place yourself with someone that's doing the right thing, with someone that's doing good, that somebody talking the right talk. This is what we need to be doing in the community. We need to change it, men. We got to start being leaders. We got to start being the foundation block for our families. We got to look like we are strong men with courage, endurance, respect, honor. This is what we need to be doing. We need to have all those things, a good character. We need to have a good character, men. We need to be uplifting and upstanding. I don't know what we're going to do, but we're going to continue to pray. I do know that. But we got to come together and have some open forum, some open talk on how we can change our lives and how young men can change their lives and the way they don't have to live on the street. They don't have to be on the block trying to make a hustle to make some money to be then possibly being killed or shot or in jail, in prison for the rest of their life, you know, getting a bad record for yourself. This is time for us to change. We see all the dangerous stuff in the world. It's time for us to change. It's time for us to do what God wants us to do and put your best foot forward. Right now, we're going to turn your attention back. We're going to play the more of the Father's Day sermon that was at Ambassadors for Christ at Fox Spot Road, Lewisburg. Yours truly, Reverend Nino Ackridge, was the speaker. Amen. For the Father's Day, we want you to know that we hope that this be a blessing to someone. Amen. Listen to yesterday and listen to right now.
Amen. Hallelujah. A man shouldn't be laying around on the couch, playing his game, watching TV, eating all day, sleeping and chilling, too lazy to work, don't want to work. But a good man has been a transforming man, and he is empowered by the word. For how to win is his money. He is empowered by the word to do his best and to keep pressing. Amen. To keep pressing. You ain't got to be perfect.
That's right.
But do the best.
Amen.
For the word says, above all, taking the shield of faith. He has faith. For I shall put my trust in the Lord. I shall put my trust in His God. Somebody shout glory. Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
Amen. When I woke up this morning, I was able to see the sunshine. When I rose this morning, I was able to walk. I was able to talk. I was able to dress myself. So I have a witness this morning. Put your clothes on. If you ever dress yourself this morning, put lift up your holy hands. I'm so happy this morning. And I got a God that shook me this morning. I thank Him for allowing me to wake up to see a little thing. I'm able to talk. I'm able to walk. I'm able to dress myself. We are alive.
Yeah.
We are alive and we have life.
Yeah.
Amen. We have life.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to encourage you, Father, today, when things feel like they are unbearable, I want you to just stand tall. Stand still. And call upon the Lord.
Yes.
For He will fight every battle.
Yes.
Do I have a witness this morning?
Yes.
Is there anybody out there that tried God?
Yes.
When they in the midnight hour.
Yes.
When no child had got home yet.
Yes.
When the phone rang and you didn't know what the situation was.
Yes.
You had known that God still was in control.
Yes.
My God will touch your new body. My God will and murder and killing and abuse and envious and hatred, racial hatred, black on black crime is all around us. But we seem like we're in the middle, and something about that middle, we have not went hungry. We still have clothes on our back. We still wake up in the right mind. I don't care what kind of hell we see on TV. We are still blessed in our house. I know that's a God. He is real. He is real. He is real. God is real. All we have to do is try. Men, be encouraged. Amen. Be encouraged to be the leaders of your family. Be the leaders in your society. I love God. He has never failed. His plan always works. We might put a plan on the table. It might not work. They might put blueprints down to build a house, but the wind can destroy it. But I know that if you trust in God, lead to not your own understanding, but lead to God's understanding. And leading in His understanding is simply just following His desire, following His will, following His way. Put your best foot forward. Men, you shall not be defeated. You shall not. The enemy can't do all these nasty things to you. It seems like in the natural that all the stuff that a man deal with on the job, the pressure to keep the house together, the children, the wife, the mama, the grandma, this neighbor over here on the job. Don't you seem like that all this stuff that brothers we go through, we have lost our minds? But we shall not be defeated.
All things are possible. Oh, yeah.
And if somebody talking doubt, ain't nobody talking the same talk, then you will remove yourself from it. Brothers, we got brothers out here that can really discourage you. You tell them you want to do a call out, the first thing they'll say, man, you ain't got no money to do no call out. Well, they just done spoken to your blessing. Don't be around somebody that don't have nothing positive to say. That's for somebody here. Because it may seem like you might not have no dollars. But I know a God that will send somebody in your way. God will put somebody in your existence. And just say, man, I see what you're doing. You've been working in this community. You've been helping out with the softball team. You've been helping out with the football team. I see you a loving man. I see you love your wife. I see you love your children. And all I want to do is bless you. I want to help you. If there's anything you need, God will do it. You don't know how God will bless you. Somebody might be on their way out. God lay on their heart to bless you. They don't have any family. God might put on their heart to come by and see about you. And now you are $200,000 richer. But that's because you didn't give up on faith and you didn't give up on God. We got to start speaking some positives in our community. I know the community might not look up to our standard, but we don't have to worry about that. Just empower them that they can do better, that they can be better, and that they are somebody. Yeah, that's what we need to do.
Thank you, Jesus. That's right.
With God, all things are possible. See, I want to tell you this morning that when fathers do best, great things begin to happen. I'm going to read it again. When fathers do best, when they does best, great things begin to happen. Fathers, sometimes we don't get the recognition we feel. But fathers are the foundation of the house.
Amen.
I ain't never seen anybody put a house up without a foundation.
Amen.
If you think you can put up four walls and without the foundation, that house won't stand. But if you put up a foundation, a solid rock, one that's centered around God, ain't nothing in hell on this side of the earth can shake it, can move it. Unremovable foundation. Men are the foundation. That's why the enemy attacked the men. That's why we see more men not doing their responsibilities, because the enemy know that if he can cut off the foundation. We are the foundation. He don't come to us, but he tries to affect us. Adam was the foundation. He didn't go to Adam. He done went over there and said, I know I can't go to this problem. I know God told him what to do, and he ain't going to do it. So I'm going to go over here to Eve, his wife, because I know he loved that woman. He done jumped through hoops for that woman. He'll tear down a wall to get to that woman. He'll stay all night on the phone for that woman. That's why he went to the woman. Amen. Well, what's the key then to being a successful father? Glad y'all asked me that. Psalms 128 says, blessed is everyone that fears the Lord, that walketh in his ways. Fathers, we are blessed when we fear the Lord and walk in the way he wants us to walk. For thou shalt eat the labors of thy hands. Happy thou shalt thou be. shall plant. It shall be of your hand. And if they be good seeds, it shall be well with thee. The Father, our God, is seeking true worship. Who will worship him in spirit and in truth. Let us respond to this prayer and get back to the heart of God. God is calling us back. He is calling us back to his heart. And we need to pray. Pray like Jeremiah prays. Restore us, O Lord. Take us back to you again. There's an old song that they used to sing. Take me back, dear Lord.
Take me back, oh Lord. Take me back to the place. Take me back to the place. Amen. Amen. We thank and praise God for another Monday night. Amen. I pray that something said in the sermon, continual sermon, amen, that uplift you, that encourage you to make it. Fathers, men that are listening, be a blessing in your life. Put your best foot forward and keep on going. Amen. Because God is still in control. I don't care what it looks like. It do looks rough sometimes. But I tell you what, if you have faith, continue to believe in God that he's going to make a way out of no way, then you will be victorious. Amen. We'll see you here tomorrow for Tuesday night. Amen. Sports Minutes. Amen. I love you with the love of the Lord. And we will be playing the rest of this. Amen. Possibly Wednesday, Thursday night.
SOS, I need you daily. Yeah. Can't lie, say the pain don't faze me. My God, who gon' help these babies?
I've been in the fire so long, I can't get burned no more. I thought you was putting out the flame, but it was rain from the storm. Thoughts over my head, making me stressed all day long. They won't let me rest, S on my chest. I ain't that strong. I need a lifeline right now. 911 won't do. My back's against the wall now. Done all that I could do. I prayed every prayer, went to every service like I know how. Just a ship without a sail. I'm lost without your help. I need help. Oh, truth, sometimes I don't, but it ain't about my will, it's all about what you want. Yeah. Family used to be first, things getting worse in my home. My brother is hurt, we need a word, it's too far gone. I need a lifeline right now, 911 won't do. My back's against the wall now, done all that I could do. I prayed every prayer, went to every service like I know how. Just a ship without a sail. I'm lost without your help. Lord, it's me this time. Said I'm crying, Lord, yeah. Yeah. Help. I just can't make it if I don't have you.
I need a little help now, see. I feel left out, I can't tell my right from my left now. But my mama's crying cause my daddy's dying. He got pains all in his chest now. My daughter's having these nightmares. I might be wrong, but I'm right here, yeah.